Hi, welcome to Sunil Maths Tutorial, TIFR 2019 Part A, Real Analysis Question. Let us see the problem. Let fn, n is equals to 1 to infinity, be a sequence of functions from capital R to R, defined by fn of x is equals to 1 by n, fn of x is equals to 1 by n, exponential of minus n square x square. This is nothing but 1 by n, e power minus n square, x square. Then which of the following statements are true? Both the sequences fn and fn dash means first derivative of fn, converge uniformly on capital R. Neither fn nor fn dash converge uniformly on capital R. Fn converges point wise but not uniformly on any interval containing the origin. Fn dash converges point wise but not uniformly on any interval containing the origin. Let us solve this problem. Fn be a sequence of functions from capital R to R, and fn is given by fn of x is equals to 1 by n exponential of minus n square x square. It means 1 by n e power minus n square x square. You observe that. Let us find, you have to find both fn of x and fn dash of x are either uniformly convergent or point-wise convergent. You have to check both the functions fn of x and fn dash of x are uniformly convergent or point-wise convergent. Observe. Let us find its limit. Limit n tends to infinity, fn of x is equals to limit n tends to infinity 1 by n into e power minus n square x square. You observe that as n tends to infinity, this 1 by n tends to 0. So, our limit is equals to 0, which is equals to f of x. Therefore, we conclude that limit n tends to infinity, fn of x is equals to f of x. This shows us the sequence of functions fn of x is point-wise convergent. Let us check the uniformly convergence of this sequence of functions. So, to check the sequence, to check the uniform convergence, let us find Mn. What is Mn? Mn means supremum of mod fn of x minus f of x. Supremum of mod fn of x minus f of x, which is equals to supremum of mod fn of x 1 by n e power minus n square x square minus f of x. F of x is 0. You get simply 1 by n e power minus n square x square. Take pi of x is equals to one by n into e power minus n square x square. E power minus n square x square. Let us find pi dash of x. Pi dash of x 1 by n into minus n square into 2x into e power minus n square x. So which gives a result of, you observe that minus n 2n x square e power minus n square x. To find the supremum, suppose pi dash of x is equals to 0. So if pi dash of x is equals to 0, then we get minus 2n into x square into e power minus n square x square is equals to 0, which gives a result of x is equals to 0. Minus 2n not equals to 0. E power minus infinity becomes, so variable, simply the variable x is equals to 0. Then mn is equals to, you get simply 1 by n into e power minus n square into 0, 1 by n. Limit n tends to infinity, mn is equals to limit n tends to infinity, 1 by n, which is equals to 0. Yes. Hence, by mn test, Weierstrass mn test, limit n tends to infinity, mn is equals to 0. Hence, we say that the sequence of functions fn is uniformly convergent. The sequence of functions is uniformly convergent. You observe that. So now we conclude that f n dash of x is equals to minus 2nx into e power minus n square x square. So let us find its limit. Limit n tends to infinity. Limit n tends to infinity. F n dash of x is equals to minus 2nx limit n tends to infinity minus 2nx divided by e power n square x square. E power n square x square. As n tends to infinity, the denominator tends to. So let us find by applying L'Hospital rule, this term becomes limit n tends to infinity minus 2x divided by 2n into e power n square x square into x square. So which is clearly equivalent to 0. Let it be f dash of x. What it means? Limit n tends to infinity, f n dash of x is equals to f dash of x. Implies as the sequence of functions f n dash of x is pointwise convergent. You observe that. Here, limit n tends to infinity minus 2nx by e power n square x square. As n tends to infinity, you get infinity by infinity form, which is undetermined form. By applying L'Hospital rule, differentiate this term with respect to n as n tends to infinity. So you get a derivative of minus 2nx is minus 2x. Derivative of e power n square x square is 2nx square into e power n square x square. Very clear. As n tends to infinity, 1 by n tends to 0. So complete term becomes 0. You observe that. So the sequence of functions f n dash of x is pointwise convergent. Let us check the uniformly convergence of this one. Mn is equals to supremum of mod f n dash of x minus f dash of x. It is very clear. Supremum of mod f n dash of x minus 2nx into e power minus n square x square. So take g of x is equals to minus 2nx e power minus n square x square. E power minus n square x square. So you observe that it becomes find g dash of x derivative with respect to x minus 2n into e power minus n square x square. Minus 2nx into minus 2nx into again minus of 2nx into e power minus n square x square. You observe that by making minus 2n e power minus n square x square common, minus 2n e power minus x square minus n square x square common, you get 1 minus of minus, again we're making minus common, minus 2n e power minus n square x square, you get 2n x square. Suppose g dash of x is equals to 0, which implies as 1 minus 2n x square is equals to 0, which implies x square is equals to 1 by 2n. What is x? From this one, you can write x is equals to plus or minus 1 by 2 root n. Now let us find Mn. Mn is equals to supremum of modulus of minus 2n into 1 by 2 root n e power minus n square into x square means n square. x square means 1 by 2n. So observe that, which is equals to minus 2 root n e power minus n by 2. Now find the limit n tends to infinity mn is equals to limit n tends to infinity minus 2 root n e power minus n by 2, which tends to minus infinity. So let us, we are using modulus. So it tends to plus infinity. So limit n tends to infinity mn not equals to 0, which means fn dash of x is not uniformly convergent. Not uniformly convergent. But fn dash of x is pointwise convergent. But fn dash of x is pointwise convergent. We observe that fn converges pointwise as well as fn of x is uniformly convergent. Fn converges both pointwise and uniformly convergent. But he given that not uniformly convergent. So option 3 is wrong. And then the option 2, neither fn nor fn dash converges uniformly on capital R. It is also wrong. Both the sequences fn and fn dash are converged uniformly on capital R. You observe that fn convergent uniformly on capital R, but fn dash not convergent on uniformly capital R. So option 1 also wrong. So you observe that fn dash converges pointwise, but not uniformly convergent on the interval containing the origin. Option 4 is